Hello, Phil here from Wings of Pegasus and welcome to another analysis video. If you enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. On the agenda tonight, we're looking at the King Elvis Presley, and this is going to be an interesting one because I did a video on James Burton, who was Elvis's lead guitar player, and people asked me in the comments section if Elvis could actually play himself or whether he pretended to play. And I thought I'd have a look at this video, and given my experience of teaching professionally for 15 years, I'll be able to break it down and explain a few things for you guys. And I might interrupt it maybe halfway through just so you guys can see what I'm referring to and don't forget by the end of the video when I start to mention a few things about him playing or not playing. So let's get Elvis up on screen and see how he gets on. This is going to be Baby, What You Want Me to Do. And I'm just going to jump in here. As always, the link to this video is going to be in the description below, so you guys can check it out without any interruptions if you want to. But getting straight into it, Elvis could play the guitar just the way that we look at the intro, and we've got this classic blues run going up and down the fretboard. And it's one of those things that there's particular things about his playing that gives away how much he played or how much he didn't play. And we will be getting into that, but certainly running up and down the fretboard, all of those fret positions are absolutely correct with what we're hearing with the audio. There might be a little bit of synchronicity that's out just because of the delay of the audio compared to the video, but he's getting all of those positions correctly. When we're going into the standard progression that we've got here, classic blues here, we're going from our E to our A, and then we've got a B shape as well. Now, Elvis plays the B seventh shape, which means that you don't have to do any bar chords, and anyone that does play guitar will know that bar chords can be a little bit tricky, a little bit more of a stretch required, and it takes a bit of time to get used to bar chords, whereas Elvis has negated that issue by playing that B seventh. And you'll be able to see the second player who's playing some rhythm as well. He'll be doing bar chords in the background just to thicken up the sound a little bit. The other thing that you'll notice with Elvis's playing is that when he's playing fills, he's literally going to the open strings of the guitar. So he'll be playing an E chord and he'll be letting go and coming back on, letting go, coming back on. Same with the A. So that's what he's doing to fill the space between the chords. Again, if you knew a few fill shapes, you might go to those, but Elvis very much is throwing in those open strings to get that fuller sound. Another thing that sticks out about Elvis's playing is the amount of downstrokes we've got in there with that right hand, because a lot of players really do prefer to use a lot of downstrokes rather than alternate picking, because what you'll find is that the faster you want to play, the more you need to work on the technique of the right hand in order to get more notes per second, and that's generally when alternate picking will come in. But if you just want to start playing with great technique, then you can alternate pick all the time, even when you're playing slow passages with that left hand. But Elvis is just always doing the downstrokes here. So fortunately, he's not going to be tested in terms of any speed, because it's a really cool blues line we've got going going on here is not going to suddenly start shredding. There's no need for it. And generally, in terms of popular music, you won't find any need to shred when you're just getting something down melodic. And I always say about the top bands that have had massive hits have always had a guitar player who plays slow and melodically and just dashes a little bit of speed in there now and again. It's never a shred fest. And the shot that we've just left is a great indication of all of those downstrokes that Elvis is using on this turnaround run that he's throwing in there. And this is exactly the same run every time he plays it note for note. So he isn't extemporizing, he's just very much got that run down. Another telltale sign as to where Elvis is with his playing in this performance is the finger independence. What you'll see when you're watching a top lead guitarist is that they have independent control of their fingers so that they can play the most efficient way possible in order to get from note to note and from string to string. That's an absolute necessity once you start putting together lead sections and speeding up your playing. But Elvis here really does have every finger moving at the same time. So he doesn't have that independence yet, but he still is playing lead here. We have got single notes following each other on this turnaround. One of the first things that I noticed about this video was that Elvis doesn't look awkward when he's holding the guitar. It's not as if somebody has given him an alien object and told him to pretend to play it. And it is so obvious when that happens because the left hand isn't doing any of the right shapes and the right hand looks really awkward as well. And that's another telltale sign, is that Elvis here is anchoring that right hand on the body of the guitar, which means it gives him a solid position to pick out the strings and to be accurate with it. And that is something that only comes with playing the guitar for a long time. And there's one very specific part of this video which absolutely shows you the standard of Elvis's playing and where he was ability wise because at 1:55 he's just strumming away with those chords and then he rocks back on his guitar and he loses the anchor point with that right hand. Now, when you don't play a lot, losing the anchor point with the right hand, going away and then coming back, if you're trying to pick one particular string, you will miss it because you're not used to where those strings are because you haven't played enough. Whereas Elvis, when he comes back, he gets straight back into his anchor point and, more impressively, he gets into that turnaround run with all of those down picks and he's absolutely on that A string. The first note of the run, I think, is a B. So it means that he is so used to coming down and getting that string. And you can imagine that when you play the guitar, hitting a string, it is such a small target. When you're coming from so far away, you have got to have played for a hell of a long time in order to get that accurately. And Elvis absolutely does that. And quickly, just before we get back into it, by anchoring that right hand as well, Elvis can get a little bit more rotation and fluidity in the wrist. And this is something that you'll notice if somebody is pretending to play or with real beginners, they have a real solid right arm where it's almost like a plank of wood that's just moving as one. Whereas when you're watching accomplished players, there's a little bit of give in the wrist. And the wrist is what generates the speed in the strumming as well. So you'll start to see that that right hand becomes a lot looser. There's more wrist rotation in players that have been playing for a long time. And certainly Elvis, by anchoring that right hand, he's got that rotation in there. So again, it's not a totally alien movement to him. Let's check out the second half of the video.
Oh.
And there we have it. So again, a few little things that I can point out from that second half is that when Elvis does go into those single note runs like we had on that intro, he is using the same finger to move up the guitar. And this is something, again, that once you start to play a little bit more, you'll find that especially in the blues here, you'll be using first finger. And then rather than skipping up two frets, you just use your third finger and then the little finger. So it's one of those things that Elvis obviously felt more comfortable using one finger to go up and down the neck. And then also when he changed over to the A string, again, same thing, just one finger moving up and down. So that's his technique. That's the way that he used it. Maybe if he did play a little bit more, he might transition to that first, third, and little finger. But again, he doesn't need to use the third finger, little finger, because he can get the sound that he wants just using one finger moving up and down the fretboard. It's not a deal breaker. Another thing that he does well is just moving into those chord shapes from the lead notes and vice versa, and also that little turnaround run that he repeats a few times as well. And this is all pretty much clean. You can't hear any buzzing. And again, that's a telltale sign of a beginner player, just not applying too much pressure to the string and getting that fret buzz from particular notes. But here, you know, it's a really nice clean sound that we're getting from Elvis. I do know that obviously we've got that second rhythm guitar, but the rhythm guitarist, when you're watching his positions, obviously we can't see it all the time because of the camera angles, but there are points at which he isn't playing the same as Elvis. He might be playing a bar chord when Elvis is playing those runs and going to his B7th shape. The second guitarist will be playing the bar chord version. The thing that Elvis is all about, just oozing confidence during the performance, and that is something that would not be possible if he was given a guitar and was pretending to play, especially in this kind of intimate setting in terms of this gig where you've got somebody who might be just 2 meters away who can see your hand positions, and you more often than not have got guitar players in the audience as well, so they'll be able to suss out straight away that he is pretending to play. Obviously, I can tell you that he is playing the guitar. He's got all of those correct hand positions, correct lead positions. Even though he is playing it with one finger, it's still all correct. There's nothing that he is pretending to play here. I'm going to throw it back to Scotty Moore, who was Elvis's first lead player, because Scotty said of Elvis that he wasn't an accomplished musician, but he did have a great sense of timing and rhythm. And that's certainly something that we can pick up from this video, that he's not going to be going into lots of lead sections, but he can play exactly how he needs to and is required to for his own music artistically. And that's all you can ever ask of an artist. And a lot of people get hung up on this idea of wanting to sound like another player or wanting to play or sound better. Whatever better is, that's going to vary from person to person. That definition is always going to change. As long as you can play at a level that allows you to express yourself the way you want to musically, that's all that matters. You don't need to learn techniques that you're never going to use. Obviously, it's great to have them if you want to go into different genres, but if you can just play to a level that allows you to sound like yourself, that's all that's needed. And that's all every guitarist since the beginning of time, especially the successful ones, that's all they've ever concentrated on, is sounding like themselves. And that's why they've become successful, is because they sound unique. They're not sounding like all the other players. And just to put this video analysis in a nutshell, I'd say about Elvis that he is a competent player. You have to be. In order to play and sing at the same time with this level of confidence, you can't fake this. Back in these days, you could not fake anything because the technology simply didn't exist in order to tune somebody's voice, to pretend to play guitar for you. It just wasn't possible. So the level of ability back in the 60s, the 70s, and before those times, had to be top notch because you were always trying to beat the other artists musically with the sound. They couldn't just put it through an effects processor that would do all the work for you. You actually had to do the work yourself. And it's an old idea, but believe it or not, there are still some musicians who are doing it the old-fashioned way. Unfortunately, a lot of mainstream artists aren't as good as they might be perceived to be on shows and live videos that then get overdubbed afterwards. It is a sad state of affairs nowadays, but it's great to look back at somebody like Elvis picking up a guitar and playing, even though he might not be able to melt your face with a solo, he doesn't need to, but just having the confidence to get up there and just play and do something that's great. You can't really say anything bad about this performance because it's got everything you look for. It's got great melody. It's got great vocals as well. And it's just got great showmanship and confidence. Even though Elvis is sitting down, he is still absolutely selling the performance. It's got such a great vibe to it. But thank you to everyone who suggested this video for me to take a look at. And keep those suggestions coming in the comments below. Let me know what you guys think. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. And I'll see you guys at the next one. Rock!